All right. What's up, sons? It's Blind Rod with Son of a Tech once again, and we have a huge security risk announced by Nicehash that we need to go over involving Phoenix Miner real quick. We're just going to go over what happened, what Nicehash posted, what's going on with the original files, and then how you can check your current zip file to basically confirm whether or not it is the original one. That doesn't mean, of course, that it couldn't have something malicious. Just to be clear, but before we get into it, here's a word from our sponsor. Today's sponsor is myself. To support the channel, click the join button down below and you will be able to access our privately hosted Rocket Chat. Selecting the $1.99 option will get you access, and after that you just need to head on over to the membership tab, scroll down and expand out your membership perks, and find the section for connecting on social media. In that section there will be a secret registration URL for Rocket Chat where you can sign up and enjoy talking with other cryptocurrency enthusiasts and miners without scammers, spammers, or bots. Alrighty, so yesterday Nicehash released a blog and we have it pulled up right here. All right, there we go. So if you take a look here, Nicehash has said that it's come to our attention that Phoenix Miner is no longer available for download from its original download location. Control sum from new download locations does not match the value published by the developer on his channel. This brings the possibility that Phoenix Miner's author wants to cover his tracks and disappear, or even do something malicious. So that's the accusation that Nicehash is coming out with. And then from there, of course, they go on to say that you should reinstall your operating system if you have used Phoenix Miner on your PC, or from what I can tell, if you've used Nicehash from your PC. It is a possibility here that Nicehash had downloaded the incorrect version of Phoenix Miner and is trying to cover their tracks as well. So what can you do to basically protect yourself? First of all, you can essentially do a checksum check here. And on the first page of the Bitcoin Talk forum, you can come down and find at least the original files right here and the SHA-1 code. And what we're gonna do is essentially show you guys how to do that. So I have the Phoenix Miner 5.5C downloaded here. We're gonna go ahead and run PowerShell, and then we're just gonna change directory over there. I can type, don't worry. So you'll just run a quick change directory, okay? And then once you're in the folder where you have downloaded the original zip file, you're going to want to run this command, which will be posted down in the description below. And then it will give you the result for the SHA-1 hash of the zip file. And you want to confirm that it matches the SHA-1 hash of the zip file, of course, on the Bitcoin Talk thread. Now, like I said, this doesn't mean that there's not a possibility of something being malicious in there still, but it does mean that you downloaded the correct version. This is something I've been working on going over for all miners, and also why I talk about not using miners on Windows PCs that you have any personal data linked to or accounts linked to, because it can be very dangerous. Now, the next portion of this is going to be talking about the mega download being taken down. As you can see here, mega download has taken down the original Phoenix Miner download from the Bitcoin Talk thread, but that is the same here, which this is actually for EWBF, for EWBF's miner, as well as all miners appear to have been removed from mega at this time. So it is quite possible that essentially Mega has decided that their policies are against cryptocurrency miners, and that's the reason they have gone down, and not necessarily that the original author took it down. In fact, the actual error is this link is unavailable as the user's account has been closed for gross violation of Mega's terms and services. If they had cryptocurrency miners against their terms of services, that's why all of these files are getting taken down off Mega. So it could just be because they're against, of course, like I said, cryptocurrency miners, so don't freak out yet. Definitely use the PowerShell command I've posted down in the description to go ahead and verify that you have the correct one and that it matches the Bitcoin Talk thread. And then from there, if you were running Nicehash, it does sound like they may have actually been running a compromised version of PhoenixMiner. Also, I don't know how they feel about the remaining one. So either way, you want to be very cautious around the entire situation, but nothing has changed from any kind of security standpoint in the past when it revolves around mining and what we talk about on this channel, which is you should never keep any of your personal information on a machine that you are mining with, because of course all miners are flagged as viruses, and because of that, if you allow it through your system, at that point you've given it full control to do whatever it wants, even outside of mining cryptocurrency, which poses a security risk. Funny enough, in the video that we're going to be releasing later today, we talk about this in comparison to mining OSs or mining operating systems like HiveOS, RaveOS, and Simple Mining. So if you're interested in that, definitely hit the like, subscribe, and notification bell. It's my son's birthday, so I'm getting out of here. This is the quickest thing I can do to point you guys in the direction that you should be headed. So I'll see you next Tuesday. If you enjoyed this content, you can check out more crypto content on this playlist up here. Or, of course, go ahead and subscribe for more in the future. Adios.